The hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from Kitab al-At'imah, the chapter of food and the etiquettes of food. The narration is mentioned by Sa'id ibn Zayd radiallahu anhu. Sa'id ibn Zayd radiallahu anhu, he is from the Ashara Mubashara, from those people who have been given glad tidings by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in one sitting to be going into Jannah, inshaAllah. Sa'id ibn Zayd radiallahu anhu, he's the cousin of Umar al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, and hence was married to the sister of Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu. It was the house of Sa'id ibn Zayd, as well as Fatima bint al-Khattab radiallahu anhuma, in whose house the introduction of Islam for Umar radiallahu anhu happened. So he is the narrator of this hadith. And Sa'id ibn Zayd قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الكمأة من المن وماؤها شفاء للعين متفق عليه وفي الرواية لمسلم من المن الذي أنزل الله تعالى على موسى عليه السلام. Sa'id ibn Zayd رضي الله عنه narrates, he says that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, mushrooms are a kind of manna and their juice is cure for the eye. And another version of the narration by Sahih Muslim, it is mentioned that manna, which is refers to in this hadith, it's similar to what was given to Prophet Musa alayhi salam, as Allah mentions, wa anzalna alaykumul manna was salwa. So this hadith gives us many lessons that we can take from this. Number one is about al-kam'atu, which is refers as mushrooms. And now we know that mushrooms are of many kinds. You have the highest mushroom. The biggest industry in the medical field is the medicinal mushrooms that are being sold. They say by 2023, the pricing of that will go up to almost $50 billion. So, and they have so many benefit in the medical field that has been mentioned. And of course, there are different categories of those mushrooms. And of course, in this hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, from many benefits, one of the benefit that he mentions is cure for the eye. Ibn al-Qayyim mentions in Tibb al-Nabawi, rahimahullah, that there are many ways that you can use mushroom by adding in water or many other ways, as was described by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, squeezing it or even roasting it and it's extracting liquid from it to have this usage. Also, Imam Nawawi rahmatullah alayhi mentions in Sharh of Imam Muslim Sahih that we had a lot of people in our time which had different diseases of the eye, and they use mushroom to cure it. And he says, I have seen it with my own eyes. People who were not able to see, by using this, they were able to see. Also, it is mentioned in Imam Tirmidhi's Sunan on the authority of Qatada, who is a student of Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu. He says that Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu had a daughter who had some illness in her eyes. She was not able to see. She used to see blurry when she used to see, she would see blurry things with her eyes. And Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, every time he would collect 7 mushrooms, and he would squeeze the water and put it into a small bottle, and then he would just give drops of this water, and eventually Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave cure. So there are many traditions found in Sahaba's practice, as well as the teachings of Nabi alayhi salam. And from the medical perspective also, there have been given a lot of benefit to this. Now, just by listening to this hadith, you might just go and pick any mushroom from Walmart on the shelf, take it home and squeeze water from it, and then start putting it, and something happens to your eyes, and then you start complaining. I do not recommend for you to do that. If you do want to use what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, then use it to the right source, get a medical opinion, see what type of mushrooms are beneficial for this, and you know, do some research, ask someone who knows, and then use that mushroom which is recommended for this treatment, and then inshallah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give cure, as the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam describes. So this is one of the plants, and the reason, and it's mentioned that the resemblance is given by man. Now Imam Nawawi rahmatullah alayhi says this plant, mushroom, it is something that grows without even making any efforts. You don't need to actually go in and start harvesting to grow mushrooms. Mushrooms just grow anywhere. If you go into a lot of grass which has not been cut for a while and the rainwater comes and the mushroom starts to grow. So it doesn't require any effort. Similarly, man, which was revealed upon Bani Israel by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they didn't have to make any effort. It was provided. This is why in Arabic language they call mushroom shahmul ard, the flesh of the earth. The flesh of the earth, it's something that the earth grows without any effort, and it's very accessible, and a person can take many benefits from it. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to practice these sunnah of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. You might be using it in many of your ingredients. I mean, a lot of people buy pizzas with mushroom toppings and stuff. So, you know, have it with that. This is what the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam actually have recommended for us to use. It brings that love and muhabba and connection with the Nabi Alayhi Salam and the foods that he has recommended for us to use. We ask Allah to grant us the understanding and the ability to practice. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. Jazakum Allahu khairan. Subhanallahi wa bihamdi. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Wa nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.